Hi, Mike Athanas here from the VxRail technical marketing team, and in this video, I'll be providing an overview of CloudIQ features and functionality for VxRail. To access the CloudIQ portal, customers can use their support account credentials. In order for you to view your VxRail clusters, you do need to ensure that there is an active connection with Dell Technologies Cloud using the embedded connectivity agent on your VxRail clusters. The Embedded Connectivity Agent is a software-based secure communication channel for remote support services and is also used to send telemetry data to Dell Technologies Cloud for services such as CloudIQ. On this screen, you can see the System Health page. The VxRail clusters are listed in the HCI tab. If you have other Dell storage, networking, or data protection products, you would be able to view them in the associated storage, networking, or data protection tabs. From this System Health tab, you can easily view all your VxRail clusters and gauge their individual health with simple aggregate health scores. The health score has a range of 0 to 100. Green indicates that the cluster is in good health with a score between 95 and 100. Yellow means that the cluster is in fair health with a score between 71 and 94, and red means poor cluster health with a score below 71. Let's take a closer look at a cluster that has a poor health score. The first tab you see for this cluster is for its health. On the left, you see the number of reported health issues categorized by components, configuration, capacity, and performance. On the right, you can see details on each health issue. You can click on a specific issue for a recommendation on how to resolve it. Here, you can see that there is a reference to a KB article to help resolve the issue. Let's move on to the Inventory tab. The Inventory tab provides a detailed report of the cluster configuration. You can find information such as the vCenter server version, VxRail HCI system software version, and the license types for the software installed on the cluster. On the bottom half, there is detailed information about the hardware in the cluster. First is the host view, which provides information such as the hostname, serial number, and VxRail model. There are other views that you can select from the drop-down menu. The disks view shows all the disks in the cluster along with where the disk is installed, the model number, manufacturer, and capacity. The power supplies view lists all the power supply units along with their serial numbers and part numbers. The version information view provides a detailed list of component firmware and driver versions installed on each host. Lastly, in the Cluster Inventory tab, is the Data Stores subtab. Here, you can find the data stores configured for this cluster along with the usage capacity information. The Capacity tab provides an historical view on how the system capacity has been consumed and forecasts future usage that can help with planning for additional capacity investments. You can also customize the time range for the chart. Now onto the Performance tab. Here, you can view line charts for the cluster's CPU utilization and memory utilization for the last 24 hours. As you move your mouse cursor over the line chart, you can see the timestamps and the recorded measurements against them. The next capability set I'd like to cover is VxRail Lifecycle Management. Let's navigate to the System Updates page. On this page, the pie chart at the top represents the VxRail software distribution across all your VxRail clusters. At the bottom half of the page, the clusters are listed in a table. There are three VxRail lifecycle management operations supported with CloudIQ: pre-check, download, and update. You can perform pre-update health checks on VxRail clusters. This is a typical operation to run when preparing for a cluster update and you want to know whether the cluster is healthy enough to successfully complete an update. The sequence of steps would be to first click on the pre-check button, then select which clusters you want to run the pre-update health check operation, and then select the target VxRail HCI system software version. From there, you can click Run Tasks to perform the operation. Notice that there is an estimated time for how long the operation would take to complete. I won't show you the actual health check operation in this overview video, but I'll cover a couple more areas on the System Updates page. You may notice that some of the clusters have a status of not supported. Hovering over the status will show you why they are not supported at this time, which could be a health-related issue. The download operation is used to download the update bundle for the target version onto the VxRail Manager VM of the VxRail cluster. The update operation is used to initiate the execution of the cluster update with the update bundle downloaded onto the VxRail Manager VM. The update is actually performed locally on the cluster, but can still be tracked from CloudIQ. Notice that you can select multiple clusters to perform these operations. For the update operation, an additional add-on license does need to be purchased and applied to every node in the VxRail cluster for you to be able to update the cluster from CloudIQ. Now, let's navigate to the virtualization view. The virtualization view organizes the VxRail clusters by their associated vCenter servers, similar to how you would view them from the vCenter server UI. To most VMware administrators, this view is probably a more familiar way to monitor VxRail clusters. On the left side, you would traverse the navigation tree from the vCenter server, data center, then to the VxRail cluster. On the top is a banner that shows the aggregate numbers for cluster health scores, alerts, and VMs. The Summary tab provides a list of clusters and information along with individual CPU, memory, and capacity usages. The information in this tab is context-sensitive based on what is selected in the navigation tree. Here, the Alert tab digs deeper into the information provided on the top banner by providing a list of alerts being reported by each cluster, along with descriptions and time when the alert was raised. The VMs tab lists all the VMs along with resource usage information and which cluster they belong to. And this concludes the CloudIQ for VxRail overview video. In this video, we covered the system health reporting features available for VxRail clusters. We also went through the various views available to you on CloudIQ and learned about VxRail cluster configuration, including component firmware and drivers, as well as storage drives. And we also covered the three lifecycle management operations you can run for VxRail clusters: pre-update health checks, update bundle downloads, and initiating cluster update.